Correspondent for the National Journal, Chris Freites, and congressional reporter for the Washington Post, Ed O'Keefe. Ed, good to see you back here with us. All right, Chris, let me start with you this time. We're talking about a deal could be reached. The president modestly optimistic. I'm hearing that word a little bit thrown around this morning and this afternoon, optimistic. So what does that deal look like now?
Well, TJ, I thought maybe, you know, your bumper music coming back in should be Final Countdown, because here we are with just a few hours left and the Senate is at work. And, you know, a lot of optimism out there and a lot of happy talk coming out of Friday's White House meeting. But I wonder, you know, the sides still remain pretty far apart. Reid and McConnell on who is rich. What's the definition of wealthy? Is it $250,000? Is it $400,000? They still haven't hashed that out yet. There's the addition of unemployment benefits. How do we extend those? How do we make sure middle class families aren't hit by the AMT? So there's a lot of issues on the table. And what I'm hearing at this point is that they're not close yet. And, you know, the leaders decided not to bring the Senate into session today so that they could, you know, work behind the scenes to try to come to a deal. You have two of the leaders here who are both deal cutters, but even if they come with a deal, still big questions about whether or not it would pass the Senate. And then the bigger question, could it pass a House that has shown to be very, very anti-tax increase of any kind?
Ed, let me get you in here. And you heard Chris say there that he's not hearing that the two sides necessarily are close right now, but all the optimism I hear being talked about today so far has to do with Reid McConnell being able, people feel pretty good that the Senate will be able to come up with something. The issue is still, once it goes to the House, the prospects there.
Yeah, but you know, bringing in Reid and McConnell, they're the guys that have cut these deals in the recent years, whether it's the debt ceiling or other issues. It often comes down to the two of them to put something together that can quickly pass the Senate and then head over to the House. And in talking to Republicans, they've made it clear that McConnell's not going to bring forth anything they can't get at least a majority of Senate Republicans to vote for, and likely then enough Republicans in the House to join with Democrats conceivably to pass this thing. There's always the opportunity for the House to amend it whenever they get their hands on it, which would mean it'd have to come back to the Senate potentially. But, you know, it's pretty clear at this point that if they're going to put anything together that can be voted on, it's going to have to be something that has enough Republican and Democratic support in both chambers. And what does that include? It includes sorting out, you know, whose taxes go up, whether it's $250,000 or $400,000, whether unemployment benefits are extended, whether there's a patch for the AMT, whether perhaps they throw in this this concern about milk prices that might go up because they never passed a farm bill this year. If those types of things are in there and everyone acknowledges that they're going to come back next month into February to sort out the remaining issues, then conceivably they could get something done before we all pop the champagne on Monday night.
Okay, but popping champagne seems like a far-fetched idea given where we are with all this. But Chris,
we'll need it. Chris and I will need it because we've been working so hard.
Well, Chris, if we talk about a deal now that's not going to be a grand bargain, who knows what they'll be able to throw in there? Maybe they just do a bare bones type of a deal just to make sure people's taxes don't go up on January 1. And then we go, whew, okay, we avoided the cliff. How long then before the three of us are right back here having some kind of a conversation about our next crisis, our next deadline, our next cliff?
I think it'll be very, very close, TJ, because what we're seeing is a kind of showdown mentality where the leaders only partially fix problems, they leave big problems on the table, and in this case, it's going to be the debt ceiling. When is a nation's credit card going to be maxed out? The Secretary of the Treasury tells us December 31st is when we hit our limit, and he has to take extraordinary measures for the next 6 to 8 weeks to make sure that the government can pay its bills. So we'll be back here very, very shortly asking the question again, how do we ensure that there's a deal struck where we can raise our debt limit so that we don't default on our obligations. Republicans are looking at that as an ability to leverage more spending cuts, which by all accounts won't be in this deal going forward. If we do get a deal, it's largely just on taxes here with the first of the year approaching, and we will be again back here talking about how do we deal with a debt ceiling debate that is sure to rattle the markets perhaps even more than this fiscal cliff debate has.
All right, Ed, Chris, gentlemen, I'm going to have to leave it there. Good to see you both. If I don't see you again, Happy New Year to you. Thanks for being here this weekend.
You too,
Happy
TJ.
New Year, TJ. No.